So if you're wondering if solar power is a viable option to power your life, the simple answer is absolutely yes. We have lived full-time in this vintage camper, who we lovingly call Hamlet, since 2012, in every season, every environment, all over the North American continent. And we have been off the grid and solar-powered nearly 100% of the time. Stick around for the next 5 minutes and we'll show you how we have built a simple, flexible, and energy-dense system that not only powers our life, but also our mobile business.
So let's start with the solar panels. We have two 100-watt Renogy flexible solar panels on the roof of the camper, which we installed in 2021. Now, they still look great after many years of use in just about every possible weather condition you can have. Now, we rely on the solar array to keep our camper's battery bank charged up for most of the time. I mean, it's really not about how many panels you have on the roof, it's how they all work together. So in addition to that array up on the roof, we have this Renogy 400-watt lightweight portable panel, which is a workhorse, and it folds up quickly to store away when we don't need it. And it plugs in to the front of the trailer right here. This panel is a lifesaver during various times of the year. So in the summertime, when we want to keep the camper cooler, we can park it in the shade. Now with this panel out on a 30-foot extension cord, it can be in the sunshine while we're under the forest canopy. Now when it isn't very sunny, this panel also gives us extra surface area to increase our solar collection. And especially in the late fall through the early spring, when the sun angle is low and the days are short, this panel is at that perfect angle to grab that sunlight and transform it into energy. Let's show you the rest of the components inside Hamlet.
Here's where the solar power comes through in a small hole in the roof that is sealed with a cable entry housing. And the cables run down the wall behind this support and into our solar cabinet. Here we have a switch that allows us to select either the roof panels or the portable panel, which connects out on the tongue as Hutch showed you. Because they are different size panels, 100 watt versus 400 watt, we would lose efficiency if we connected them to the same charge controller. But we'll get to that simple workaround in just a minute. Now that solar energy flows into a 40 amp charge controller, which connects to two 100 amp hour Renogy lithium iron phosphate pro batteries. So that's a total of 200 amp hours for our little space. All of our batteries are self-heating, so they can handle those freezing temperatures. The power then flows from the battery to the DC fuse box, which runs our lights, fans, and charges our smartphones, small electronics, and various camera batteries. This energy also flows into our 700 watt inverter, which electrifies three different AC outlets, so that we can use an appliance with a standard household plug, such as our satellite internet, laptops, heating pads, immersion blender, tiny shop vac. It's basically all the stuff we need to live and work full-time and travel comfortably. Now, the components in our solar cabinet have evolved over the years, significantly. It's a perfect fit within a space of about 30 by 14 by 12 inches. It's compact, energy dense, and very efficient.
Now let's look at our other source of power generation, our towing vehicle, while we're driving. Now in the back of the truck, we have a 50 amp DC to DC charger that efficiently charges the 100 amp hour LifePo 4 Duo Heat battery, which powers our 12 volt ice cold fridge freezer. This small battery runs our fridge for up to 4 days on a single charge in the summertime and closer to 10 days in the wintertime. Small and energy dense is the name of the game here. This 50 amp charger can also handle a solar panel input as well. So when we've been parked in the same place for a few days, we can keep this battery topped up with our 400 watt portable panel without having to start up the truck. You're starting to see just how important and versatile this panel is in our life. And here's a trick. This $10 battery switch and some extra cable gets us a whole lot more flexibility with our off-grid system. We can actually switch this to charge our house batteries in Hamlet rather than just the fridge battery when we're driving. So in just a couple of hours, our house batteries can be recharged and ready to go.
Now there is one more piece to this puzzle that I just love. If we plug our 400 watt portable panel into the DC to DC charger and have Hamlet's battery selected, we can transform our 200 watt solar array into a 600 watt solar array, and this charges up our system in no time flat. Now earlier I mentioned that we cannot have both solar arrays going into the same charge controller at the same time. And that's true. But here we have two charge controllers going into the same battery bank, which is a great way to combine different solar array wattages.
And lastly, we have this AC to DC charger, so we can recharge our off-grid batteries when we have access to shore power. Now, it's rare that we even need this option, maybe 1-2 times a winter or during some really terrible weather. But it's always a great option to have this as a backup, just in case, because we never carry a gas-powered generator. And of course, we have a Renogy One-Core monitor dedicated to each of our systems so we can keep tabs on things. Now, here's a quick look at that solar diagram, which illustrates this whole scheme for you. We have all of these components linked down in the video description. You can also find a link to our free downloadable worksheet that will help you size your own off-grid solar-powered system. And as always, feel free to reach out with questions in the comments. Hit that subscribe and that like button. Thanks for watching. We'll see you on the road.